Hello, Pythoneers. Do you want to enhance user experience and make your scripts feel more interactive? Adding a progress bar can give users real-time feedback on task completion. Today, I'll show you two effective ways to implement progress bars in your Python applications. Stick around to find out how. Let's get started. The first one I want to show you is the TQDM module. We start by importing the TQDM module and installing it using the command pip install TQDM. Next, I'll walk you through the basic code. In this example, I want to iterate through a list called QS that contains 7 items. For each iteration, I want to update the progress bar. To do this, we need to initialize TQDM as a context manager. We begin by using with TQDM as PB for the progress bar, and then pass the length of the QS list to the total parameter. Inside the manager, we iterate over each item in the QS list. During the loop, we perform the tasks we want and then update the PB. If we run this code, you'll see a simple but effective progress bar updating after each step of the iteration. I add a short delay to make the progress more visible. And that's the basic setup. If this works for your project, thanks for watching. Haha. But if you want more advanced features, here's what you can do. First, let's look at the update steps parameter. This lets you control how many steps of the progress bar per iteration are done by the PB updates. For example, if you set it to 5, the progress bar updates every 5 steps per iteration. Here is another example where it updates by 2 steps. You can decide how frequently you want it updated. This is how you can reflect the real workload done by every step. Next, you can add a description to the progress bar using the DES parameter. For clarity, I extract this description into a variable and pass it as progress bar. When we run the code, you'll see this description appear in front of the progress bar. If you want to change the layout of the output, you can use the bar format parameter. I create a bar format variable where you can choose what to display and in what order using a config string. You can include more outputs using curly brackets like in an F string. For example, it shows the remaining time, the current item of items, and the progress bar itself. When we run it, you'll see the progress bar with the new layout. I use pipes to separate the output visually. If you want to explore more options for bar format, just run the command tqdm --help. The documentation provides everything you can do with the progress bar. I'd like to highlight the flexibility of the bar format inputs. You can customize the output in many ways using these. You can also change the look of the progress bar itself by using the ASCII parameter and adding custom characters. In my example, I use 3 blocks, the first for the background, the second for the head of the bar, and the last one for the filled part. The head in this example can be hard to see when I run the code, but I hope you get the idea behind it. For better visibility, I show another option using an X in the middle. When we rerun the code, you'll see the X, running ahead of the filled progress bar. Lastly, let's talk about the ncol parameter, which defines the width of the bar. The default is 100% screen width, but you can set it to any integer value. I think 70 columns is a good readable width. What do you think? If the ncol value is larger than the screen width, you'll get an overflow effect, which could be useful in some cases. And that's the basics of the TQDM module. Check out the link docs for more information. Let's take a short break, and let me thank you for watching so far. Will you use this progress bar like this in your project? Now, let's get to the second module I want to show you, the Alive Progress Bar. We start by importing Alive Bar from the Alive Progress module and installing it using the command pip install Alive Progress. We'll use the same QS list with 7 items to compare the 2 progress bars. Next, we initialize Alive Bar as a context manager, setting it up as bar and passing the length of the QS list to it. Then, we iterate over each item in the QS list, performing some work, simulated here with the sleep. After each iteration, we use the bar function to update the progress bar. And that's the basic code you need to run the Alive progress bar in your console. But hey, basic is too boring for us. That's why we can customize it. The first thing I want to show you is the bar parameter, where we can change the style of the progress bar. The classic style adds an arrowhead to the bar and uses an equal sign as the body, but there are many other variants to choose from. To see all the available styles, we need to import the showTime function and the show class from the styles package. When we run the Showtime function, it displays all the available bar styles in the console. As you'll see, there are some pretty fun and quirky options to choose from. Before I show you more features, let me extract the bar input into a separate variable for clarity. I'll call it bar and then pass it back into the progress setup. Just like in the TQDM progress bar, we can also set a title, but here we use the title parameter, which makes more sense to me. I'll use the same string, progress bar, as the title. When we run the code, you'll see the title displayed on the left, next to the bar. If you're not happy with the length of the bar, we can customize it using the length parameter. By default, it's 40 characters according to the docs. I've set it to half, using 20 as the input. Another really cool feature is the ability to add spinners to your bar, which looks pretty fancy. We can do this by using the spinner parameter. For example, the wait input displays a small please wait banner on the right side of the bar, while the triangle option shows arrowheads moving left and right. If you want to see all the available options, it's time to put the show class into action by reading the global variable spinners inside the show function. As you'll see, there are plenty of variations to choose from. It seems like the developers had some fun creating this module, and honestly, I like it. As of now, I haven't found a way to customize the layout like in the TQDM module, but feel free to check out the docs yourself. Maybe you'll discover something. This module comes with a lot of extra features, like a pause mechanism or loopless use, and it's definitely worth exploring further. And that's it all for today. Which progress bar method will you implement in your next project? Share your thoughts in the comments. Remember to subscribe for more exciting Python tutorials and hit the bell so you never miss an update.